All right, here we go. One, two, and...
Thank you. Meditation.
That was new.
That's the first time
Jesus
I said
that. Got Jesus.
Jesus got into them.
That's new.
Exaltation, Jesus.
Maybe they are listening. Those are good photos.
All right, here we go.
Great.
Give me a four. One, two, and a.
Thank you.
It's probably the band parents.
I know. Yeah, I'm good. At least it's something. At least
that's
I know
true.
They're alive.
That's true.
All right.
Month of Rose. Month of Rose.
I'm confident you got this one. I'm confident you got this one.
Okay.
You played this one perfectly last time. So, got this. I wanted your other hand, but that's fine, too.
One song that you get to listen to, I only played it once. I don't even know why.
Okay.
I guess maybe it was the first time I got to play the E flat. Maybe. I'm like, I just get really sentimental playing it. I don't know why. Okay, here we go.
I thought that was Eddie.
Ready? Yo.
Shh. Come on. Clarinets, it's you at the beginning of saxophone. One, two, and... Yes, when I'm waiting. Are we good? No? Okay, go. Here we go. Ready? No, is she saying yes?
She's saying yes.
Okay. One, two, and.
Freshman year, you could never have predicted our high school experience. From the first time we walked into the school, to looking at this year's underclassmen, and deciding we were never that small. From our first high school sports tryouts, to bittersweet senior nights. From making our first friends in ninth grade orientation, to seeing them today in caps and gowns. From our first great day of teaching and learning to our last, we have each made memories that we'll carry with us as we set out on the divergent paths that now lie in front of us. Today, we celebrate each of these memories and everything we have accomplished together. Today, we are a class of dedicated students, award-winning athletes, talented artists, and loyal friends. We've come a long way and left some pretty big shoes to fill back in the drive. Who knows what the future holds for each of us? What opportunities will arise, what doors will open, and what doors we will kick down. The one thing I know for certain is that the class of 2023 will leave a mark on this world. I can't wait to see what the future holds for each of you, and would like to thank you for the privilege of serving as your class president these past few years. I would like to leave you all today with this quote from Tua Tagovailoa. When you get where you're going, don't forget, turn back around, help the next one in line, and always stay humble and kind. At this time, I will be passing the podium to our senior class vice president, a 2023 long jump state champion, and my friend, Afemi Kalajaye.
First, I would like to congratulate
congratulate the class of 2023. We finally made it. But let's not forget where we started. I remember, as many of you likely do as well, being told how fast these 4 years of high school would go by, and brushing this class off because high school seemed to last forever. But standing in front of you now, I can confidently say that time really did fly by, and I'm grateful for all the memories our class has made together, and cannot wait to see where each of your journeys takes you as we leave here today. Now, I have the privilege of introducing you to our student body president, Mason Dancuzzi. I've had the pleasure of knowing Mason since our freshman year, when he was just a few inches shorter. Throughout the 4 years we have been at Athens Drive, he has grown into the strong, intelligent leader he is today, whether it is in the classroom or on the soccer field. While some may know him as Mr. Involved or the voice on the intercom during the morning announcements, he is also a friend, someone who always smiles at you in the hallways. Mason's time here at the Drive may have gone by fast, but his presence and contribution will make an everlasting impact. UNC is lucky to have him, but go Pack. It is now my sincere honor to welcome to the podium Mason Dancuzzi.
Thank you, Kate, for your kind introduction. And good afternoon to all the families, friends, staff, and students who are joining us today. My name is Mason Dancuzzi, and I've had the honor of serving as your student body president this year. I would like to congratulate all of you sitting before me on the milestone you are accomplishing today. This is no small feat, and for reaching this point in your life, each of you deserve to be extremely proud. Now, while I'm sure you're all tired of hearing my voice in the morning, I hope you'll lend me your ears for one final message. I would be remiss if I did not begin by acknowledging one of the most important people to our high school careers. This is a person who has dedicated hour upon painstaking hour to us and our success. I've heard stories of his arrival to school in the wee hours of the morning and his infamous 4 a.m. time-stamped emails. This person has truly given his life to us and the Athens Drive family, and this year he announced his retirement. On behalf of Athens Drive, thank you, Mr. Mayors, for everything you have given us. From your time at Groton to sitting here with us today, you have made an ineffable impact on thousands of lives. From the numerous teachers that have hailed you as the best boss they have ever had, to the countless students that have credited you with the success they've had in high school, you've truly changed our lives for the better. Wake County Public Schools will truly miss you in your undying wisdom, compassion, and love of living. With that being said, and as I'm sure Mr. Mayors is aware, all of you graduating today belong to a one-of-a-kind generation. That is Generation Z. We are a powerful group, a group with the will to do great things and truly change the world. Although your life is changing right now, and the world before you may seem daunting, I encourage you to take a step back and remember where you have come from. Look upon the lessons that you have learned and the memories made within the walls of 1420 Athens Drive. Perhaps our fondest memories were made with the people we met, whether it was the mini-conference titles our teams took home, meeting Enloe at Enloe's homecoming, or hitting cookout on Western for a bite afterwards, the experiences were endless. Many of you dedicated time to clubs, too, and student organizations where your focuses were centered in problems in our community and around the world. In the classroom, we found out that high school is arguably the most crucial stage in our development as young people, and now I'm not so sure young is the proper qualifier. Over the past 4 years, we have changed unimaginably. We've found insightful lessons telling us what we do not want to hear and opening our minds to new ideas. Oftentimes, we have come upon these new ideas through controversy, something we are very familiar with. You're probably sick of hearing this for the trillionth time, but we are the OG COVID babies. It was during our freshman year that COVID-19 gave us quite the unconventional introduction to high school, effectively cutting out a year of in-person education. What started as extra spring break led to an uncomfortable period of change and adaptation. Although many of us felt the effects of this pandemic directly, we had to persevere, eventually making it out on the other side. Our years in high school have been filled with many setbacks and controversy, but it is through these challenges that we have grown stronger. We have unique firsthand experience with perseverance, an invaluable and integral quality that will serve us well during our next steps in life. As I said before, Generation Z is a generation of doers. People who do not expect change to happen miraculously, but people who will be the change. Create a positive mark that cultivates a better future for yourself, your peers, and posterity. And when you go about making this positive change and it seems like too much, I want you to look back on these 4 years reminding yourselves of the perseverance each of you possess. It's been a long road for us all, and in the words of Aubrey, Drake, and Graham, we started from the bottom, now we're here. So let us go forward today with the lessons we learned, continue to strive for success and change. Take with you the times to remember, the friends, teachers, and administration, and continue to make your name in the name of Athens Drive proud. Congratulations, class of 2023. Let's do this.
Cafeteria duty during the World Cup. had to spend one day in the cafeteria watching the early games of the World Cup and see pockets of students gathered around computers and cell phones cheering together. These diverse groups of students were celebrating their love of the sport and their love of country. But even more than that, it was the honoring of fellow students who are passionate in their enthusiasm. Too often we're told how polarized we are and how different we are and divided we are. I believe that we're much more alike and united in love than people give us credit for. We need to build that unity to appreciate and celebrate more of those things that bind us together. The second lesson we should learn is that we need to leave everyone and everything a little better than we found it. The Japanese World Cup team provided a wonderful example of this as they cleaned their sideline and locker rooms after each game and treated each opponent with respect. I love this. Leave everyone and everything better than the way you found it. It's simple to visually look around and make things better for our environment than the way we found it, but it's not so simple with people. I believe we need to look at people around us at school, at work, and at home, and ask, are we leaving them better than we found them? Are we adding kindness, love, appreciation, affirmation, inspiration, or something else? We need to use the Japanese soccer team as an example and realize that we're responsible for cleaning up our own messes with things and with people. The final lesson I want to leave with you today is to do everything with passion. Wherever you're watching the World Cup games, including the cafeteria and classrooms, it was easy to see the students that brought passion to that experience. We need to have that same passion for life, for each other. Just as ripples spread out when a single pebble is dropped into the water, your passion can create far-reaching impacts in our world. Your single pebble can create not just a ripple, but a wave of positive energy that can profoundly change this world. Have courage and be confident in what you've learned and what you have inside of you to make that difference. While we can't ignore that the world has many challenges right now, I trust in the future because I trust in you. You have the knowledge, skills, and attitudes that will make this world more peaceful, just, and caring. This year, you've genuinely cared for and you've stood up for what you believe in, and I can't wait to see how you unite with others to use your passions to leave this world better than you find it right now. Congratulations, graduates. I'm proud of you, and our entire school family today celebrates your academic achievement. Well done.
Make sure you watch. Make sure you watch. You don't get carried away.
Okay, listen now. Really important. One person in the section gets the folders and brings them up here. Another person gets tutors and brings them up here. Go back to your cases, and we're going right out of here, okay? Great job.
Let's go.